Electricity, to most people, is a miraculous force that is magically available whenever it is needed. Just flip a switch, push a button, or turn a knob, and you can turn on the lights, operate the TV, cook food, play video games, and much, much more, 24 hours a day, 7 days a week. However, there is nothing magical about electricity. In fact, massive, complicated equipment and many skilled employees are necessary to generate electricity and deliver it to customers. Electricity can be produced in a number of ways. LG&E Energy uses falling water or hydropower, natural gas engines, or steam to turn huge turbines to generate electricity. Actually, we generate about 95% of our electricity with steam created by burning coal, millions of tons of it each year. Coal is delivered to our power plants almost daily by rail or barge. It is placed in stockpiles or sent directly inside the plant. Heavy-duty conveyors carry the coal to huge storage bunkers that hold up to 1,000 tons. From there, the coal feeds into a pulverizer that grinds it into a very fine powder. The powder is blown into boilers that are up to 14 stories tall and lined with thousands of water-filled pipes. Burners in the boiler act like torches to ignite the powder. The water in the tubes heats up to 1,000 degrees Fahrenheit and creates steam. Pressure created by the steam powers the next component of the generation process, the turbine. We have a number of plants located throughout the service territory, and each has several turbines. The turbine is an assembly of a shaft and wheels covered with blades similar to those on windmills. The high-pressure steam passes over the blades, causing them and the shaft to turn at a very high speed. At the end of the turbine shaft is an electromagnet, a magnet inside of copper wire that turns and produces electricity. As electricity is generated, it is sent to transformers that increase the voltage of the current. Then it begins its journey to homes and businesses throughout the high voltage transmission lines, which are like superhighways for electric energy. Along the way, electricity takes detours to transmission and distribution substations, where the voltage of a portion of the power is reduced. The electricity is eventually channeled into distribution lines, which carry the power into neighborhoods like yours and business areas. Before the electricity enters a home or business, the voltage is again reduced to a level suitable to operate everyday items. Electricity then travels through a meter, which records the amount which is being used. Electricity is a wonderful asset that powers most of the best things in life.
The individuals in this video are experienced line technicians who have undergone many hours of training to work around high voltage power lines. They are professionals who know the critical importance of following proper safety procedures and wearing special protective equipment to ensure their well-being. Never, ever attempt what you see here and never experiment with electricity. Use extreme caution in all situations involving electricity and remember, safety first. And always stay away from down power lines.
Hello, my name is Julie. I'm a line technician for Louisville Gas and Electric. Welcome to the high voltage demonstration. The electrical lines and equipment you see behind me represent the same things you may have in your own yard or on your street. They may look harmless, but today we will show you just how dangerous and destructive electricity can be. During our presentation, we will explain to you how electricity travels through this equipment and other objects that may come into contact with it. Also, we're going to show you some of the special tools and clothing we must use to protect ourselves while working around electricity. Most important, always stay away from down power lines.
That was a fuse blowing. Hi, I'm Johnny, a line technician for Kentucky Utilities. When this happens out on our lines, electricity usually goes out somewhere, and it's our job to come out and fix the problem. Working around electricity is risky business and extremely dangerous. More than 1,500 people a year die in the United States because of electrical shock and burn accidents. Most of these deaths occur because of carelessness. Either people don't understand the hazards of electricity or because they take it for granted since it is invisible. But it is very real. Electricity is generated at a power plant. The electric current travels through the lines at different levels of voltage or force. The levels of some of our transmission lines are as high as 500,000 volts. The levels of our primary distribution lines, which are the ones in your backyard, are 2,400 volts and 7,200 volts. The voltage levels coming into your home is 120 and 240 volts. If you accidentally make contact with a voltage source of any level, it would cause electricity to flow through your body. The electricity needed to operate a 100-watt light bulb is three times more the amount needed to kill you. Electric current is always seeking a path to ground, and by ground, we literally mean the earth, and that path can be you. If you touch an energized piece of equipment, the electricity will travel through you to the ground. A metal ladder, a pipe, tree limb, kite string, TV antenna, or any other object that will conduct electricity can give the current a path to ground. If you touch one of these objects while it is in contact with electricity, electricity will go to ground through you. When this happens, the result is potential shock and burn and even death. Today, we're going to show you some ways people make accidental contact with electricity. Our unit operates at 7,200 volts, which is actual line voltage. We all work on equipment at this voltage and higher. However, we are trained professionals with years of experience. We follow strict guidelines and use special tools and safety equipment to protect us from the dangers of electricity. Now, here's Robbie to tell you more about that.
Hi, I'm Robbie, a line technician with Kentucky Utilities. This is some of the special equipment we wear on a daily basis to protect us from the hazards of electricity. First, our clothing. Our clothing is made from a special flame-retardant material to protect ourselves from the hazards of electrical burns. Also, we wear dielectric hard hats for head protection. Dielectric meaning that this material would not conduct electricity. It's very important we have eye protection. We always wear safety glasses. We have tinted lens glasses for daytime use and clear lens glasses for nighttime use. We always wear steel-toed boots, also with dielectric over boots. These boots are rated for 20,000 volts. Most important are our gloves and sleeves. They're rated for 20,000 volts and are tested in our lab every 3 months. We also wear leather covers to protect our rubber gloves. It's important to inspect our gloves and sleeves before each use. We perform a visual inspection, looking for cuts and tears. We also perform an air inspection, testing for small pin holes. A hole the size of a pin hole can allow enough current to travel through to cause serious injury or even death. In addition to all this equipment, we use many special tools that will not conduct electricity. Next, Donnie is going to demonstrate the strengths of electricity and why we need this protective equipment.
Hello. My name is Donnie. I'm a lineman for Louisville Gas and Electric. Even though electricity is essential to us at work and home, there are many dangers associated with power lines. Our lines carry 7,200 volts. The structure behind me is similar to the lines and equipment you see in your own yard and on the street. It also carries 7,200 volts. We will use this equipment to illustrate what happens during a power outage and some of the causes. We also will demonstrate how everyday items can conduct electricity and just how dangerous those energized items can be. As you heard earlier, when power goes out on a home, a trained line technician will respond to the outage. Once our line tech arrives, he may use a high voltage detector similar to what is being used here to determine if the voltage lines are energized or dead. If the lines are dead, then the line tech will walk the lines to find out what knocked it out. As you can see, a tree limb fell across the power lines. Our trained line tech will remove the limb, then restore service to your home. Trees are very dangerous when they are growing into power lines, and in this case, they fall on the power lines. Watch as our trained line tech will demonstrate how dangerous trees near power lines are. Trees will conduct electricity. As you can see, if you touch a tree with a power line through it, it could kill you. You may think you can use a stick or tree limb to push power lines out of the way. As you can see, that is not true. Climbing in trees near power lines or using limbs to push lines out of the way is very dangerous and could result in serious injury. All poles used by utilities are a path to ground. That is why we have to insulate power lines from touching them. Watch as our trained line techs will demonstrate what happens when a power line comes into contact with a pole. That is 7,200 volts going to ground. Please don't touch poles or other electrical devices, especially during bad weather. Ropes are used in numerous ways, but when they have been exposed to dirt, grime, or water, they become very dangerous when used near power lines. Watch as our trained line tech will demonstrate how a normal rope will conduct electricity. Even trained line techs never use ropes near electrical power lines. So never use ropes to pull poles or power lines. This could result in serious injury or death. Next, we would like to demonstrate how balloons and power lines don't mix. Balloons such as this Mylar are made of aluminum foil, and aluminum foil conducts electricity. Watch as our trained line tech simulates a balloon floating into a power line. As you can see, a Mylar balloon can conduct enough electricity to turn on this light. Balloons and kites are very unsafe when they drift into power lines. Please don't ever climb a tree or a pole near power lines to retrieve your balloon or kite. Many electrical outages are caused by animals, such as squirrels, raccoons, and birds. We have a toy squirrel by the name of Rocky, and as we all know, squirrels climb on everything, especially poles, power lines, and transformers. Watch as Rocky climbs across the power lines and onto a transformer. Many times when an animal such as Rocky gets across the power line and aground, it knocks out your electricity and results in the death of the animal. In areas of numerous outages caused by wildlife, we install wildlife protection. Wildlife and power lines don't mix. When they do, you lose electricity and the animal usually loses its life. Suppose you don't have cable TV and you want to install an antenna. At any time, you could lose control of it, and it could fall into a power line. Antennas are made of metal, and metal will conduct electricity. Watch what happens when an antenna comes into contact with a power line. That's 7,200 volts of electricity going to ground. You are probably thinking, I will not get hurt if I'm holding the antenna from the bottom. Watch what happens at the bottom. Never use antennas, poles, metal ladders near power lines. That could result in serious injury, even death. I know you've seen farmers use leather gloves to install electric fences. And I know you may think you can use those on power lines. But watch what happens as our trained line tech demonstrates a pair of leather gloves used to move a power line. Don't use leather gloves to move any lines. They are not made to protect you from 7,200 volts of electricity. Now you're thinking, I've seen that high voltage safety display and they used rubber gloves. And I bet you have some of those underneath your sink. Watch as our trained line tech shows us what would happen to you if you use those gloves to touch a power line. Household rubber gloves will not protect you from electricity. The result could be very serious injury or death. As Rob told you earlier, linemen wear special rubber gloves to work on power lines. But even with these special gloves, a small pinhole could result in serious injury or death for a trained line tech. Watch as our trained line tech shows you what would happen to a line tech who fails to test his gloves before he works on a power line. For our own safety, we test our gloves before every use. The human hand has skin and bone and blood and salt, all of which conduct electricity. What would happen to a person who came in contact with a power line? Watch as our trained line tech uses hot dogs to simulate a human hand. Direct contact with a power line could lead to serious injury, up to and including your death. Please stay away from poles, guy wires, power lines. Just call LG&E or KU to respond to those hazardous conditions.